Hello and welcome to the Noob Chat Steam Demo Saturday. We're jumping into Dungeon Defenders 1. This is a multiplayer action RPG plus tower defense game released originally on the Xbox, PS3 and PC. I think the PC was the earliest, coming out around October 2011, and the other two I think were a year or two later. This is developed by Trendy Entertainment, who I've researched are only known for their Dungeon Defenders series. There's Dungeon Defenders 1, which I'm playing right now, Dungeon Defenders, I think it's First Wave, which is a mobile game, and Dungeon Defenders 2. I'm not sure if it's out yet, but if it isn't, it will be very soon. So, without further ado, I'm going to jump in. I've already played this quite a bit with Moon Pigs and Maxolotl quite a while ago, so if you want to look back at our previous videos on that. Now that I've got a good, sort of good, internet connection and much, much, much better computer, it shouldn't lag for me. I should be able to do this pretty damn well. Let's see. Options. We get to play online, play local, which would be offline, or... Let's see. Options. Down here you got general options, tutorial, reset, split screen, if you have two people on the same computer, maybe? That'd be quite interesting. It's been a while since I've had a look at this game, as I said. Controls, let's see, WSD, jump is spacebar, activate is E, voice, I don't think I'll need that this time. All the options look good. I haven't tuned this beforehand, just so you know. I think I'm gonna jump into my own. Sorry, no, it's okay, thank you. I'm going to, oh well, yeah, see, look, there I am, JDOS 99, level 71. For the purpose of this, I think I'll create a new hero.
Donning his robe and wizard hat, the apprentice is eager to delve deeper into the world of the arcane. Under the guidance of the Grand Magus, the apprentice has learned the art of conjuration. While summoning towers of mystical defense to aid him, he blasts his enemies with waves of magic from afar.
That is the apprentice, if you didn't hear that. He's basically a very ranged fighter who can summon things to help him. Next character.
Each knight in training, the squire, upholds the honor and nobility of his kingdom with every slice of his blade. Building defenses of brute force and limited range, the squire prefers melee weapons as his instruments of justice. Bludgeoning spikes and whirling blades unleash the rage he bestows upon his foes.
Okay. So, the knight is more of like a melee tank. Everyone can put down defences in this game, so it's not just the mage that can conjure things. As it said, where is it? Honour and nobility. Yeah, he's wearing heart boxes, as you can see. Quite the honourable fellow.
Trained in reconnaissance, wow. The sleek and slender huntress deploys deadly traps and explosives. But do not be fooled by her appearance. This elegant she-devil is trained in ranged weaponry, and is sure to always hit her mark. Launching a volley of arrows from the shadows, the enemy never sees her coming.
Okay, so I can't remember this character, but the player skill for her is quite high. Where is my one? There's another one here. The monk.
Once a peaceful and passive student, the monk has been called from his solitary meditation and forced to take up arms in the defense of his land. Only he, through his expert spear fighting skill, can avenge the death of his master. Channeling his aura, the monk uses energy to heal his allies and cripple foes.
So, here's the monk. He's a bit of a cleric paladin type. I played him. I didn't realise his player skill was master before. I might try playing a different character this time. Is there anyone else?
The sly trickster bold. I missed.
Okay, so just additions? Quite a few additions. The perp of this, I'll be apprentice. What's that? Hold on a second. He sounds a bit like Kenny from South Park, where you can't really hear what they're saying. So for that purpose, I'm going to make his equipment orange, if I can. Is that as orange as I'm going to get it? More or less. Secondary. What's the secondary color? That. Kenny's is green, I think. Accessory. I'll just mix it up. I'm going to be a pretty mage. Is that all I can... Oh. Santa! That's very weird. Can I actually use these? Oh, wow, I can. I thought they were... Oh, yeah, some are. not working. What can I use? I can use a leprechaun. I don't think so, though. I think I'd rather use the default. Spirited looks good. There you go. Nice customer characterization with skins and colours there. I'll name him. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alonzo! Alonzi, Alonzo. And there he is. He looks happy, doesn't he? Jumping in out will show you how it usually works. I'm sure you know how a normal tower defense works, but this is a pretty nice game. I want to show you it, and I'd want to play it, to be honest. That's the only reason. Maximize your wards, minimize your combat, something. Okay, what should we play first? These are the levels you get from Royal Garden, Rampart, Endless Spires, Summit is the boss level. I'm going to jump back into easy, because I don't want to die. Challenges, I don't think I'll do any of the challenges. I'll just want to do one of these, I'll say. I'll start off I think this is the first level. I didn't think it, oh no, here it is. Yeah, clicking up, here's the first level, the Deeper Well. On easy mode, this would be just by myself. Was on the land of living legends. Long ago, brave warriors across the realm stood together against an immortal evil known as the Old Ones. Damn it, guy. From the struggle, the champions locked away the power of the Old Ones inside Eternia crystals. Recently, the realm's heroes, called to a faraway crusade, have left the younger Cairhien to tend the castle and its chores. Bored with their dreary duties and imagining action and adventure, they unleash an ancient force that has long been dormant. Ah, oh, Galeo, I am. Heroes in training had to grow up quickly. Together they defend the Eternia crystals to those who would seek to resurrect the ancient evils. Dungeon Defenders. And here I am. There's my crystal. I believe I can customize that as well, but I didn't see the chance. So I'm just jumping in now. Left click is to attack. I get points now for health, attack damage, speed, casting rate, and I can change the levels of my defenses as well. I'm going to upgrade my damage first, I believe. I may not need much defenses. So, let's see. First level, I don't have any things, I don't think. So I just have to jump into. Oh, there might be a chest somewhere I can get. Yeah, there are chests down there. So if I open these chests, I'll get some souls or points. There you go. And then I can use this to put down some tower defenses. Oh, I can't hold much at the moment. Let's see. 6. Oops. Okay, I'll just put this back a little. This is going to be, what's this, a magic missile tower. It shoots things on. So where's the crystal? It's going to be up there. So where are they going to come from? That door. That's it for the time being. So I'll put it a little further down. There we go. And I believe I can start now. Oh, I can put another one down. I'll put one down on the other side, and then I'll start. I don't know how exactly to start, but we'll see. It might start for me if I'm lucky. Okay. Options. Controls. Doesn't say here how to start. Okay, maybe I have to click on the crystal. Activate to ready for combat phase. Okay. Combat phase. Let's see how these magic towers work. Oh god, I've got a chest. Let's go that down there. Yeah, they don't do too bad. Not much damage though. I could do a bit more, I think. I'm not used to playing with this guy. I'm used to more of a fast melee type, the monk. Moonpigs used to always play apprentice, I believe, and Maxolotl was the knight. There you go. He does sound like Kenny, I swear. It's not just me, is it? Wave 2. I would like to put down some further enchantments, but since this is a new character, I don't suppose I have any more other than number 6. Can I upgrade anything else? No, I need a few more souls before I can, yeah, souls. Okay. Ooh, special move. Right click is a special move. I forgot that. Okay, let's just jump into another rave and I'll just shoot them all. I don't need many defenses on this. I'm the best defense. Where are they all coming from this time? Oh dear, starting to get through a little bit. Let's go for my you shall not pass mode. Haha! Shoot, 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 shoot. Not too powerful at the moment, but I'm sure if I tried at my level 71, it would be a completely different story in this level. Oh dear. How are my towers doing? Oh dear, I think the tower's damaged a little bit. Might need to put up some honors, that's fine. Maybe I'm able to heal him or something. Let's see. He's killed 7 people. I don't know how exactly. I mean, he's not too good on the whole thing. What's this? If I press 4, what does that give me? Tower to repair. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Now I can also pick up another tower to help him out. Another one's going to come from that direction, so I'll put one facing there, and another one over here facing the other direction. So I think by now you would see what you like about this game, if this is the game for you. I don't know how much it is on Steam, unfortunately. Sorry about that. So what I will do, though, is just link the price and the Steam link to the app, its store page below in the video. As you just saw a minute ago, I picked up an item. You can pick up various weapons and armor in the game as you go along, from chests as well as random coins you can use for purchasing. What was it? You can purchase armor and stuff as well. You can purchase armor, weapons, find armor, weapons. You can purchase pets, which will help you like defenses do, except they move around with you. And yes, you use the points you can get in this to either summon defenses to help you or store them up to buy things after each match. Although after each match you get rewarded in points anyway. Let's see, I'm just going to go all out on this. This is like one of the last levels, isn't it? If I can just pick up a few more little bobs. There we go. Ooh, some more armor. Green tells you if it's better than what you've already got. Red doesn't. Red tells you it's worse than you've already got. Scrap it. We're used to seeing this as last year. Was it last year? Must have been last year. Or the year before that, when we were playing. We were so high levels, we did everything we got were basically worse than what we wanted. The days. We might need to revisit this. So maybe Dungeon Defenders 2 now. Okay, well anyway, I'm going to jump into the thingy. Let's do this. I think I can finish this game. 26 enemies next. Come on, Alonzo, we can do this. If you like this, I could continue this on as a series. The frame rate for this is very good. I can see in the top right corner, which is a lot better than it used to be for this. Oh dear. Yeah, a lot better. Oh yeah, come on, towers. Towers are doing good this time. Two towers is the way to go. Even though I shouldn't really be... Oh good, I can level up as well. As I said, I shouldn't really be getting involved, but it's fun. I can also heal things as well. That's interesting. I can heal things as the match goes on. I'll need to move. Oh, thank you, tower. Always got hit by that arrow. And you can stop right there. heal you. Who's getting attacked? Which tower? Oh, they've gone past the range that it can fire from. I'll just repair you both, don't you worry. It's good to play with friends, and definitely in a team. When it can get a little more challenging, it's not good. Oh, R does that move as well. Okay. Just you? Oops. One. Nope, never mind. 21. I'd say we should focus our firepower in the middle. They can't be attacked though. Inside that purple circle, they're immune there. So if I just have it like that, and if I can pick up another one or another two, I can have them just outside these doors. Oh, ogre, a new type of enemy, as you can see. What's this? This is a very good one. No, it just looks good. It looks shiny. Ogre up there. It's a big guy, got lots of health. As you can, oh, there it is. Red. So it's worse than I've already got, so I don't want that at all. I need to go now and set up some defenses against the ogre. Each different level, there's different enemies to face against. Some fly. You got to be careful with the flying enemies, since, you know, melee attacks, if your melee character aren't going to do jack squat against them. So you got to make sure you have some way to fight them, usually having strategic towers at different places. And make sure nothing, absolutely nothing, gets to your tower. Gets to your tower, it destroys your tower, it's all over. And the harder the difficulty goes, the less health your crystal has. So it could take one hit, it could take 10, but yeah, the less health your crystal has, the quicker it'll be to get defeated. So you need to always stay on your toes. I'm just gonna drop one and see. Where can I? He's gonna definitely go up there, so I've got no worry about him walking down that way. That'll do. And now I can go, and I'll have to keep an eye on the ogres. They're a much bigger threat than those guys down there are. And E, go for it. Come on, let's go. Bring me the ogre. I'll just start spamming him as soon as he comes out the door. There you see, big guy, got lots of health. I need to take him down quickly. Then I can work on killing the other ogre. Ooh, a nice helm there. Okay, that tower is going to be useless now. Okay, for now the tower looks like it's doing okay. Actually, I think I will actually take a look at these guys down here, because there are tons of them. If I can just get close enough to them all, I can go. And that did a lot of health damage against them. And if I do the same against these guys, there you go, just jump on them and do the Gandalf. And the tower's been destroyed. Oh no, isn't, was it? Oh, it must have been one of these ones. Here it is. They're going up to the tower. I better hurry up and get them. This guy is fire, so any fire weapons you have are resistant to him. Oops. I think there's like, what is it? Fire, lightning, poison, different types in this game. And just two left, they are. And I finish you in grand style. Wave complete. Alonso, level 2, has finished the level? Is it? Oh, I might actually have one more. Final wave. I was wrong. Don't mind me. Everything is dying. Oh dear. Award knight. Yeah, those two are dying. Shh, calm down. And now there are two ogres on each level, so I've got to be careful about that. But more importantly, I've got to keep an eye on these guys, because it's easier to deal with like a few ogres than hordes of these guys. I don't want them sneaking through either, so I've got to put more defenses up along these passages, along the tunnels. Let's see, I've got to make sure these guys are healed sufficiently. Yeah, these there, right? One draws the fire. Oh yeah, I see what was destroyed now. Let's see. Pikachu down there. And if I can pick up another one. Another one, good. Yes, there's another one. Six. And now I can... They shouldn't be able to get through this way. And if I have anything left, I'd really like to have something left. Ooh, a weapon. My first weapon of the game. A torn Malakar. So yeah, now you can see I'm using different spells. It's a different little spell thing. On them, you can get staves or staves that fire three at once, five at once. It's insane. I assume that's the same with like the ranger as well then. You can fire tons of crossbow bolts quickly. Okay, it looks like I can set something up here, or at least heal this one. Well, if I put two up here, and then I don't have to worry about this side, I'll worry about the other one a little more. Yeah, although I can still pick up some things down here, I think. Good, so I can still... Yes, what are these? Green, red. So I want to wear that one. I still look the same, as you can see. I don't know if the armor... You ever actually see the armor changes much. Okay, 60. I've got enough to, I think, put down another one and heal that one. That'd be good. If you want me to... I should have showed you more features from the... From my other character, to be honest, I think, now looking at it. But I wanted to give you a brand new perspective of how you'd be playing if you were doing this on your own or just starting as a new character, which you probably would be since not... I don't really know anyone who starts a game with already pre-made characters. And last wave. Let's do this. As I said before... Oh, crap. No, I can do this. These guys want my health. Don't... I can't level up now because it only has to be in build phase. Darn. Okay, well, let's see. The little guys down there are dropping like flies. Oh, there's an ogre down there as well. I'm going to quickly take out guys up here. Out one of them. One of their swings got me. Dealing massive damage. And, ooh. Dealing massive damage indeed. I better take out the ogres on the other side. I can, if I'm allowed to as well, I'd like to set up some towers here since I've got some points. So if anyone gets through, at least they have to deal with that. That'd be good. Oh good, those guys actually survived. I'm surprised. Everyone's actually surviving this time. And Gandalf. Just to be sure, I'll set up another tower. One tower has been destroyed over there. Well, good thing I set up the little claws. Yeah, see, one guy's getting up, but he's not going to last very long because I've already put a tower there. Let's see. And it's a lightning resistant. Unfortunately, these aren't lightning towers. And last guy. And nope, not quick enough, I'm afraid. And you are done. Now I can level up. And now I can use another spell or another defense. That's how this game works. I hope you've enjoyed. This has just been level one of my apprentice start. This is, I can't remember his name, Alonzo, I see it in the bottom right corner. For some reason I was going to say Kenny again. Anyway, I better go back to the crystal and finish the level, get back to the main screen, and then I can choose any other levels I want to play, or maybe change character. Thanks for watching, this has been the Dungeon Defenders 1 by Trendy Entertainment. If you like this, please click the link below and you can go and buy it. I look forward to playing with you if you buy it in the end. If you like this video, please give me a like, subscribe, comment. Are there any other games you want me to play or review for Steam Demo Saturday? I'd love to. So thanks for watching, and we'll find a way to get out of here. Goodbye.